Welcome to NAC Dance Podcast. Bienvenue au balado de danse CNA. In this second of two podcasts, Kathy Levy continues her conversation with Associate Artistic Director of Alvin Ailey American Dance Theatre, Masazumi Chaya. Dans ce second et dernier épisode, Kathy Levy poursuit son entretien avec le directeur artistique associé d'Alvin Ailey American Dance Theatre, Masazumi Chaya.
Now, tell me a little bit about Judith. I mean, what an incredible figure she is, Judith Jamison. She was,
of course, amazing.
His muse, one of his great lead dancers, and then took over this huge responsibility.
I'm going to call Alvin because he asked me to do it. So Alvin was in ill, and I was started taking care of the company. That time we're ready to go spring tour. I asked Alvin, I'd love to have some help. He said, oh, that may be help for you. I said, yes. So he asked me, who's in my mind? I said, I'd love Judy to come with us. And then Alvin said, well, Judy has her own company. Judy was at that
that's
time
right,
a Jameson project.
That's right.
So she's not going to be able to do that.
Is that one? Had she stopped dancing with the company at the time?
Yeah.
Okay. So you were basically running the show.
Right. So I asked, let me ask anyway, Judy, and is that all right? Alvin said, of course. And then I went to the Bill Harmon, who is the executive director. I said, oh, that's a great idea, Chai, you should do it. So I called Judy, and then whenever you're free, if Jameson Project is not performing that many times, so 2 weeks off, can you come with us? So she said, sure. So she comes, especially helping for the women. It's, first of all, she just showed the one arms up and everybody said, like that. So the perfect
a
example.
A majestic character, absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah. So, she came and then, helped me and then tour for half a year. So it's already established. So then Army asked Judy to be, if something happened, Judy, can you do that, taking care of the company? So, of course, Judy, one word, said, sure.
Uh-huh.
That's what she said to him. And then it happened. It's in December. So she came in, and then first thing is that, of course, all tied company loved Judy. So
sure.
It's a very smooth transition. It's just welcome her for anything, especially dancing, she can coach you. I mean, then she loves fundraising. So board loved it. I mean, lots of new
added
board.
Bonus.
Yeah. Totally. She loved to go, you need money. We had to do this. And so I thought company become a different energy. But still, she's so close to Alvin. So she didn't change anything. She just added. Lots of people think, Judy came and did change it. I was there and didn't feel like it changed, but that she has a new idea. She wanted to this, and she wanted bringing this choreographer. All the things added, same vision as Mr. Ailey had. So it's for me, it's not really changing, but the more exciting things happen. That was my reaction to Judy's become.
And she really has, besides her own choreography, she really was able to also widen the group of people that was able to bring in and give the company, give the dancers many different experiences.
Oh, totally. Mm-hmm. And then, I think it's another thing is Miss Jameson become, Judy. Judy become artistic director. I think it's we are financially become very healthy. And our companies, sometimes I pinch myself, how the modern dance company, and especially black modern dance company like this. And we have now new building. A few years ago, we built dig into the ground, actually build dance studio, 12 dance studio, and then basement, we have the Black Box Theater.
It's right in
the 55th and the 9th Avenue corner.
Incredible.
It's amazing.
Yes, I've been there. It's a gorgeous building.
Yeah, I think Judy really, really tried to give us a home, sense of home. When we travel so much, you would want to go home. Of course, our apartment too, but something and you go home and everybody has a okay, you know, something like that. Or also that each time it's, I have a time, so can I choreograph and I have a studio, I can play around with the student, and something. It really create a great space for us.
Did she have to deal with any pushback, if you will, about keeping the Ailey repertoire going? Was there anybody who said, "Oh, that's old. Let's
oh, no.
let's have no."
She, you know, because also I always talk to Judy. You know, this year bring back this. This year bring back that. Because sometimes some of the repertory I've been choreographed for, most of the time Judy or Dana Wood Sanders. You know, so specifically, if I see that girl can do it, I love to bring back. And Judy said, yeah, let's do it, you know. So always we, one repertory, one ballet from Alvin, we bring every year.
But the times have changed. Choreography has changed. How do you think that work has held up over time?
So when I teach streams, this time I changed a little bit because I find that the 1970s, they had videotaped it. Judy was actually dancing. This tape, I found it, and we changed a little bit to Judy's way she did her solo. Very difficult for me is if I do so across the original movement, we have to do that way. But I had to find that the individual, these new dancers, what is there about them? And I have to put in their idea of about movement, their idea of background. Mm-hmm. Because otherwise it become a to museum piece, and then it's look outdated. So I'm really every day challenged for like a rehearsal time, and then streams. I say, you know, you're such a way that you express, you know, for the whole the body. You had to do that way. Otherwise, become stiff. And maybe at one point somebody did that way, but it's not you. But I'm not changing any step. But I wanted you to. Your experience, your education, to put it in that movement. I think that way to become a little bit new to me. Yeah.
And we all know, of course, that Revelations is like, you know, a must almost everywhere the company goes. What do you think, why do you think that piece has endured for so long?
Well, first of all, that we have 30 dancers. They don't hold back. When the curtain goes up, they do. I mean, tomorrow that somebody said that you should stop dancing. They said, yeah, I did a really good job. You know, that feel like, oh, I wish I did something. Oh, I wish. None of. I mean, every night they do something more than 100%. I think that audience can feel. And then, you know, something about joy, something about people, humanity, those words fit in the dance.
But what is it, 52 years ago this piece was?
Yeah, 1960.
I mean, of course, it's a piece also that seems to say something about the Black American experience.
Of course. I mean, this year we are not carrying, but when the 50th anniversary, we carry out the 5 minutes film, which is made how they started. What is Alvin's? Alvin used to call his memory in Texas, growing up Texas, called blood memories.
Blood memories.
Yeah. So, and so some of the baptizing at the early, I think 30s, they find a film in the lake. Everybody wearing the white, and they dip into the water. Those films they show that how they started. And then the audience experience about the revolution is that film was a wonderful film. Watching that is just about that piece is about people, about how we exist, you know, and how they help each other, humanity, you know, something like that. And I think that was I think they can relate. Even we go to China, they understand that we go to Japan, yes, you know. Mm-hmm.
The company really does tour all over the world.
Yes.
Is there any place you haven't been?
Bulgaria. I've never been there. But, you know, Poland, all the Yugoslavia, you know, those areas, everywhere, Russia, of course. I think I never been in the Central Africa. But before me, I think Judy or Dudley's group went to Congo.
Uh-huh.
But I never been there.
And didn't
area.
She take the company to South Africa?
Yeah, we did Johannesburg twice.
What was that like?
That was one of my highlights,
How so?
It's so different, which is Johannesburg. We are, sort of say selected audience going to be coming in. So we, J.P. Morgan's helped that, I think. I have to check that J.P. Morgan,
okay.
Which company helped. But we did an outreach program. And then we go to every different place. My group went to Suedo.
Okay.
This structure in the country is one. If I go to shopping mall, it's just like I'm in Europe or New York or Japan. It's so good. And then 5 minutes drive away, it's like I don't recognize here. That way difference. So when I go to Suedo, there's no bus. Mm-hmm. There's no public transportation. So they just wave, look like a little van comes in, look like a sign says someone town. They just jump in. It's just a very strange structure there. So when I go to Suedo, there's a meeting place. We just show that the invite the kids, show to them Revolution I've been buked or some movement. And then they are dancers. Those dancers, they're going to show their dancing. And we exchanged like that. And we did every day for that. It's
and a particular kind of workshop.
Yeah. And then one day I was eating a sandwich. They provide for the food. And this boy comes in, no shoes, and sitting and just looking at me and looking at sandwich, looking at me, looking at sandwich. I only bite the first part, and it's still half side, it's still clean. So you want to have this?
Yes.
So I have. And kept eating and looking at the. He was not even part of this workshop, but he came in, started dancing with us, and it's just so beautiful.
And was the audience very different than what you're used to in some of the other cities
and then
you're mentioning?
What happened is that when I was hung around with Alvin, one thing that I learned was sometimes, some performers, only selected people invited, happened, and not really local, low-income people cannot attend because tickets were first of all too expensive. Some rule in the opera house or some reason. So, but he sneaked them in to show our rehearsal or as much we get the tickets for them and stuff. So I was hung around with him. So those chances, if I have, I really do try to. And I try to get this. Do you have any extra tickets of the student? And if a student can't come to the performance because of distance and the night time, then come to see us at rehearsal. And then I arrange a stage manager and house people to make sure they can come in here.
Yeah. I mean, education was obviously very important to him.
Yeah.
Did he start the school that's associated with the company?
Yes. Yeah. He really believed that the school is very important. And I think also that outreach program and then student performance. Now every dance company does, but when I was doing that in the 70s, I never heard AAADT is doing or Steve Allen doing. Now they do have. I'm glad they're doing it. I mean, we needed to do that.
So he was very much an important provocateur around the education system.
If this information is wrong, please correct me. But
I think you're absolutely right. I think the whole sort of focus on education and residencies, particularly in the United States, is relatively recent. And I think he was one of the great provocateurs, of education. And obviously he was also teaching his dancers.
Yeah.
Were there classes in those days? Like kids from the community could come in and take classes?
Yes.
Because now you have a very famous international school, do you not?
Right. But even at the we have the. We moved to 211 West 61st Street. That day, Alvin took me to that. There is a project, low-income project there.
Housing
exists.
Project.
Yeah, it exists. And then we went to management office. Alvin said, come on, Chaya. So go there. And they, let me go with them. And then he said to management, my name is Alvin Ailey. We're opening a school next door. And then I loved this kids to come to take a class. If you can arrange, we'll do something for you. I was the open mouth. Wow. How generous this guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he could stay in any own room or an apartment. He doesn't have to do this. Walk to the project, ask them to do that. It's amazing.
And did they come?
They come, yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah.
And now the school is operated, obviously, out of the new building that
right.
you were talking about.
So a little bit far from that project area, but still successful, I think. We have now, it's called AD Extension, which is all different type of dance, and anybody can walk in and take a class.
So it's hip-hop, it's,
right. yeah,
it's
exactly.
ballroom
yeah.
dancing,
yeah.
That, that kind
yeah.
of thing? Wow, terrific.
Yeah.
And how many students go through the school? Do you have an idea?
1 point registered students is over 5,000.
Wow.
That is amazing.
That's
me.
Incredible.
Yeah.
No wonder you needed a new building.
yeah.
And the 12 studios. So Judith takes over this incredible legacy of Alvin Ailey and continues, obviously, the touring and the reach. And at some point, and Chaya, you're there with her teaching all yeah. these ballets. Are you also working with some of the choreographers who are coming up, you know, people like Ulysses
yeah.
Dove and others who are coming in to make work for the company?
Yeah. You know, when Alvin's time, he invited Bill T. Jones.
Excellent.
At that time, very few dance audience loved him. And we love him now. But it's a kind of young guy and unknown in a way. But he invited, and then we had a piece. And then now Bill T. is a
huge star.
Huge.
And Ronald K. Brown. You
yeah,
gave great opportunities to Ronald,
invited,
who our audiences have seen. Yeah.
And Camille Brown for Miss Jameson invited for us. And it's a... Both Alvin and then Judy has that eye, you know, it's inviting young people. And not only just the choreographer, but the designer,
uh-huh.
lighting designer, costume designer, both loved involve those people.
So you've had to work with a lot of personalities.
Oh, totally.
I bet there's some stories you could tell us.
It's interesting. Each choreographer has their own way. One thing is... Everybody equally same is they love our dances. So that is a plus, you know. It's less worries me, to, you know, or we don't have a, you know, cannot do his style or her style, but our dancer can do most everything. So I was very happy about it. Difficulty with the choreographer usually scheduling.
Uh-huh.
Because we are schedule of the touring is so set. So you have to come August, or if you cannot go August, we have to wait till next year or some. That heartbreaking for me, you know, not able to work with the choreographer.
That's able to sometimes bring suggestions to, were you able to with Judith to bring suggestions
yes.
of choreographers to work with?
Yes.
So did you have any discoveries of your own that you'd like to?
I liked the Mauro Biogazenti. He made it for us.
And he ran a company in Italy
yeah.
right? In
Reggio
Rome.
Milo,
yeah, that's right.
Mauro's I like. Yeah, I like
We've
him.
Seen some of his work on Les Grands Ballets Canadiens
yeah,
de Montréal.
Yes,
yeah,
yeah.
He's a very nice choreographer.
It's a very inventive. Radar from a French choreographer, I liked it. When I saw San Francisco Ballet did his work. And
Radar. Okay.
What is it? He always uses just a radar. So I'm.
Okay.
Is very stunning. He's French, but I think a Tunisian
okay.
mix.
Okay.
We have that his work also. And always Judy asked me, what do you think? You know, we always throw the name and I'm going to go see, Judy go to see. And sometimes if I find that the tape or I ask, send it me a tape and I showed it, we watch together and say, what do you think? We both always in my mind is how they fit in our current rep and also who can dance in that piece, you know, with our dancer, who that's perfect, that person's perfect. You know.
Mm-hmm. So how did you respond when Judith was looking at her own retirement? That must have been another big moment for you.
Well, I thought too soon. You know, I thought too soon, and because
so did we.
yeah, but it's, she has her own plan. So you know,
which is
she. Lots of people ask her to do lecture
uh-huh.
Tour, which is she's fantastic. She high experience to to the not only women, young women, but it's with the even guys how they do conducting their life. She's brilliant.
She's an inspirational speaker.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So she all the university, college, always inviting me. So now she has a really good schedule for that, which is, I think, lovely.
I read that her words to Robert Battle, the recently appointed new artistic director of the Alvin Ailey American Dance Theater, were very telling. I read that she said, "Remember, you're not filling shoes, but you are standing on shoulders."
Right.
I thought that was very poetic and very important. What does that make you feel when you hear that?
Yeah, exactly what the Julia, Julie joined the company as an artistic director. That's what I always felt, you know, I've been already guiding. I just go through that, you know. So I think Julie did for the Robert, and Robert's great. I love him. He reminds me a lot of Alvin.
In what ways?
Yeah. First of all, very easy to approach.
Okay.
Yeah, it's friendly. And then sense of artistic side is more human-oriented. Judy's generation, we had the really technically superb dancers we had. So we challenged them. More difficult stuff. So then now the Robert, I think he understands that. Also, so it's going to be fun.
Was it during Judy's tenure that the company grew from 18 to 30 dancers, or had it already happened under Alvin?
Oh, it happened. Alvin just 18 to 23,
okay.
And become 26, and 28, and 30.
And now it's 30.
30.
You realize how incredible that is. I mean, there are many ballet companies in the world that don't have 30 dancers.
Right.
That's a very large troupe.
Yeah, it is, yeah. And then we have a talented crew. We're traveling, I think 12 crews we have. And I think we're traveling with the cross to 50.
And how do you feel? How did you feel to then have a new artistic director again? I mean, yet another time. I mean, Judith was maybe more of a connection for you because you had danced with her. But Robert, no, a different generation, a different situation.
When I met Robert a few years ago, he came to the junior company, 82 choreograph. And then I know from director Sylvia Ward told me that, Robert, you watch this guy. And then Judy said, "Oh, I like his work." So Judy invited him to do this dance. It's called Love Stories. Actually, choreographed first section with Judy, second section Rennie Harris, which is hip hop choreographer, and then third section is Robert. That way, I met, and since then, it's like, ooh, the company needed to find some director. I think Robert is my first choice.
So you already you already had your nose on him,
because. Something about reminded me of Alvin also, and also that the sensitivity toward the dancer is very, I thought, special. It's because of how they work, this company's relationship with each one, and they're also artistic, and then also between the crew. I think Robert understood that. So this is good, you know, but already Alvin was like that. Judy is like that. Third person coming have to have that sense of relationship, creating a family, you know, in a way. We are family, but it's still we came together as a dance related relationship. It's not, we are not asking them to be a best friend, so that they respect each other for the space, respect their work, something like that. Of course, created because we hung around 24 hours for how many days?
So couples evolve
exactly.
And so children get born.
Yeah. So you become a family and they sort of stay thing, do things, but it's the next day, forget about, So that sense that Robert has. And also Robert had their own butter work, so he explained it's a very difficult fundraising and running a company. So he understands about what to do, and we give it to this huge company. You do it. So that time I thought, oh, how are you going to do? But I have a strong confidence about what he can do.
Well, what given that he's standing on someone's shoulders, what would you say his creative vision for the company is?
Yeah, I think it's since he joined the company, he haven't. To create one ballet yet. I hope next year he will do.
So the ballets we're seeing are ballets that he had for Battle Works, for his own company?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So Takademi Hunt has already been done before, and then next year we bring up some dance already he choreographed. But I think a new creation. Because I wanted him to really understand that these dancers, it's just not such series of steps, but something about him and then dancer's relationship. So I wanted him to be comfortable and about these people's, movement is comfortable for their body, and he can express what he wanted to say with this dancer. So I thought it's a good to wait 2 years to really see what is this dancer, who is this dancer is.
Do you think that he'll continue to invite choreographers in from the outside as well? So he'll his idea is also to keep it as a repertory company?
And then my suggestion is always if he's willing to do one or two Mr. Ailey's work or Miss Jameson's work included, and then, which is he thought, yes, I always thought that, which is good.
You're the backbone of this company, Chaya. I mean, it's incredible. You are the center around which many, many things revolve, even though you aren't necessarily known because you're not the artistic director. It's incredible how you have touched and connected with so many of the different elements that have made this company very successful over many, many years. Do you ever stop to think, oh boy, I wish I'd done something else?
Bob Fosse. That experience was fun. Even at the rehearsal, the audition time, we had to sing and dance upon the number, which is, I did that in the audition. Anyway, but one thing is I'd love to do is, because since 1972, anything happened, the casting to a designer to, I kind of remember. So make sure I create a good archive before anything happened. That's my focus, one of. So next generation comes in and they just go open up a book or videotape and then right away they all the information there.
How is that dealt with at the company? Are there people keeping
the
archives?
Yes, we hired this person as, and also that the half of that information went to the Congress, the library. So all that till I think Judy's time we created that. So safe place we have. So also that anybody can access.
That's great. But it's housed in the building as well as at the Congress?
Yes.
Okay.
And our house is, this archive section, we have to get the permission to get in there. But the Congress, I'm sure, library, so. Mm-hmm.
But for you, do you think that means you'd like to write a book or make a documentary? Or what is it that you would like to do tell that story?
Several things I have in mind. One of the Japanese publisher wanted to write a book. 2 years ago, we started an interview and kind of remembering, that is. And then started talking with the other dancers. I said, do you remember, Chaya, we did that? I said, oh, that's right. And they're getting bigger and bigger. And she said, you have to write for me and stuff. But so I don't know. It's a third year. We didn't read chapter 2 or 3 so far. So I'm not really sure what's going to happen. But I love to some things to put down. So
you'd have to stay home as opposed to being on the road.
Right, exactly. It's very difficult.
Yeah. Now, I've heard that you went to the White House recently. Is that true?
We did several White House. First one with the Jimmy Carter's time. We are inauguration, we danced. Also, Bill Clinton's inauguration, we danced. And same time, I went to the state dinner with Ms. Jameson for Clinton's administration time. And then we received a Medal of Art from government. That time, I met Mr. Bush and then Laura and the wife. And then we together, we took a picture and stuff. Then President Obama. Michelle always come to see us, always. President's wife always came to see us in Chicago when we perform. And then when I do D.C., yes, the president actually came, first performance. Actually, first, they call a Friday date night or something. They came to see us, and then we took a picture, and went to the box, and we talked to. And then also Michelle Obama invited us to do some special for education for kids. And they needed more active. We did. I made a program, and also this was produced by Damien, who used to dance with the Steve Ballet. He produced, and then we were part of that.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So royalty, presidents, just touring all over the world. What do you think sets the company apart from every other international company that's out there touring? I mean, you see everything. What is it that distinguishes the company?
I'm not sure. I guess we are regular people. I mean, it's not really, you know, Superman, Superwoman here. Just there's... And I can say it was these dancers and crew is nice. Those people are very nice.
But the success is incredible.
Yeah.
The success and the enduring success. The fact that still all these years later...
I think it's, you know, if you come to that building, if you go through the second floor, third floor, fourth floor, which is a school to administration of or fundraising department, these people working 365 days. It's not just that we're doing a good job and out and doing a tour, but they're the one really making a publicist to make sure that there's a good picture to be sent, interview to be done, and the newspaper to be interested in what we do. And at the same time, people make a phone call begging money for, you know, we needed to do new ballet, we need more money. It's amazing how this just huge machine works together. That's, I think, is key.
We haven't had a chance yet to talk about Ailey 2. Can you just tell us a little bit about that company? And are you involved with them as well, I imagine?
Not really, because I think 74, Alvin thought, you know, original idea was that choose from a student, make an experience for performing, and then choose at the Sylvia Waters as a director. And then, so Sylvia go around the school and then, can you just ask? You're interested in, and they make a 12 dancers group, then tour. Tour used to be only States and the Caribbean area. Last few years, they started touring Europe also, which is great. And then our company is now more than 75% of dancers come from actually second company.
And are they only doing Ailey's repertoire, or
no,
are they doing
a mix
repertoire?
And then, which is a robot started very beginning with involved with the Ailey group of second companies. You know, he gave to the second company the ballet.
Okay.
It's an interesting thing is that the Ailey 2 is yes, choose by Miss Waters saying, "Can you join the company? No audition and stuff involved." But somehow they are. Become a really professional dancer being there. And then they also, they experienced touring. They experienced for any emergency, you had to go into somebody else's part. You know that how to taking care of a costume. It's just all around it. You know, those dancers really, once we hire from that junior company, they know everything. So I don't have to do anything, basically.
No, it's incredible.
But you know, they have to come to the audition. Equally with everybody, we don't choose because your second company, you know, you're gonna have this job. No, we have the open call. So,
but of the dancers that are in the company now, you're saying a good percentage of them come from that company, which is incredible.
Yeah.
And I know they tour a lot, and they tour a lot to maybe some of the centers that can't bring the bigger company.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's I think always Alvin said, you know, dance came from people. We had to deliver back. You know, so we really go to the different places, but sometimes fast companies become too big, cannot fit in a certain area, certain theater, or certain budget. So, and the junior company can do fill it up. So, junior companies still have their rep several albums work, which is a Revolution included, and the Blue Suite or Streams they do sometime. So, still have some connection with the. People there
with the repertoire. Well, I'm hoping very much that you will take the time at some point to write something to put these archives.
I have so many stories. Like for instance, I'm sorry.
No, please tell me more.
And we were on a touring Eastern Europe, and then Kavarek, who is a composer for Streams, was a house arrest.
He was under house arrest?
Yeah.
So he couldn't leave his home?
Right. Because of some kind of political...
Where was he from?
Czechoslovakia.
Okay.
And then he couldn't travel. But we're doing his work, his music. And then we found out, we are touring with the State Department. That, you know, they don't want there to be any... difficulty, and you know, had to be country. We don't want to do any, but we're doing streams. And then I heard that Alvin heard he never heard that his music to be danced by, so we're doing it, but he cannot travel. And also that the country, half of the people, they don't even know him.
Wow.
Because they are not able to play his music and stuff. So Alvin said, well, what are we doing that night? Are we doing a night creature, something, something, revolution? Oh, it's not, the stream's not in? He said, oh, we're going to do streams. And the State Department said, no, you cannot do that. You know? But he said, we're going to do streams. So we did the streams in Czechoslovakia, but we didn't change the name. We just did it. The program said Night Creature, which is Alvin's work, but it's not Night Creature. We did the streams. And the audience is screaming, and they, you know, see what the, you know, what they're missing, and what. But at least we show that, the, you know, this is that their composer was from the same country.
Did Alvin get to tell the audience that at some
no,
point?
No, we didn't.
No,
because State Department said that we shouldn't.
Okay.
But now it's, you know, and because the last time I went to check for teaching Alvin's work, and I talked to the director and said, oh, I know that composer. We can buy a record now, CD at the store.
Mm-hmm.
But so I'm sure some way people remember, maybe they remember as a Night Creature, a little bit shame, but I think it's Alvin was such a way mm-hmm. thought about that.
Did he commission music a lot, or did he mostly use found music?
Found music. Mm-hmm. Only that when I was working with him, it's only one ballet somebody composed for him was Bird with Love, which is about Charlie Parker's mm-hmm. story. Mm-hmm. That was, I think, composed. But other than that, most of the time he find the music. Because when I clean his office and his apartment, box of tape, CD.
You mean after he passed?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You had to go in and do that?
Yeah.
Clean apartment. Or did you want to?
Actually, they asked me to clean with the Sylvia, and I did clean.
Wow.
Apartment.
Did you find a lot of treasures?
Yeah. Of course, in most of the box I filled up for that we're sending to Mrs. Cooper, who is Alvin's mother, who's separated. And a few things we thought it's nice to give a gift as from Alvin. So choreographer Danny McHale, Taddy Beatty, or Judy, or, you know, something small item we kept it for, and gave it to that this for Alvin's. And they asked me, what do you want? And I, you know, give it to those choreographer first. And then, if possible, I'd like to have one is his notebook, one of the choreographic notebook I have, landscape.
Wonderful.
Yeah, he's nothing said but the people's name and his handwriting, a little sketch, a few pages, but I like that.
Beautiful. That's beautiful. Yeah. What do you do outside of all this? Do you listen to music?
I love to see that this performance.
You other go to company, see performance.
All the ballet. I think I have every DVD of ballet published I bought.
Classical ballet?
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite?
Of course, you know, the old, you know, Borisnikov, Makarov, Nureyev, those area I love. Kolpakova I love from Kirov. I mean, who is now the coach for AAADT. I like any dance now. I correct a lot. And Karen Kane's the making of ballet to her Gisela, I have her Sleeping Beauty. Oh, Sleeping Beauty was Nureyev, was a different person for the National Canada. I have. Uh-huh. Yeah.
So you live and breathe
and
dance.
Also, I like opera.
Okay.
So I go to Met all the time whenever I have a time. And then what else I do? Yeah, those things. Oh, when I play, I like a musical. I go to play. I like Shakespeare. So.
Do you ever get to just stay at home and put your feet up?
Yeah.
You do?
No. Actually, I prefer running around with the people calling, what are you doing? Going to see it? And then we go to that, you know, one of the discount tickets place, line up and buy a Broadway show and go see it.
I do that when I go to New York too, but I'm just a visitor.
I love that.
That's great. Well, I really, really am so grateful for your time. And
you've
been a great delight. And we'd love to hear more stories. We'll have to do another chapter of this when you're back in Ottawa in a few years' time.
Thank you for inviting me.
My great pleasure. Thank you very much.
All right. Bye.
That's all for this edition of NAC Dance Podcast. Voilà qui met fin à ce balado de danse CNA. Please send us your comments and questions. Faites-nous part de vos questions et commentaires. You can email us at nacpodcast@gmail.com. Don't forget you can subscribe to NAC Podcasts by visiting nacpodcast.ca, and you can also find us as a free subscription in the podcast section of the iTunes Music Store. N'oubliez pas que vous pouvez vous abonner à nos balados en vous rendant sur le site balado.cna. L'accès est également gratuit à partir de la section balado de la boutique musicale iTunes. Dans CNA du Canada vous dit à la prochaine. Until next time, goodbye from Canada's NAC Dance.